I've read a few different translations.
I haven't seen it.
And I think that the term is a sticky term for many Christians, because since they've never found that word, therefore it must not be applicable to a Christian. And I think that the connotation that we have with that word, there's a lot of, we kind of look at it through the eyes of the world. So because when you're dating in the world, sex is a part of that, living together is a part of that, all the things that a married couple will do are a part of that. And so even though that word or that concept may not be there, I think as believers, if we're living according to the scripture and the Bible's final authority in our lives, I don't think that there's anything wrong with the word. As long as we're redefining for us as believers what that means and how that needs to be played out, I don't have a problem with that. So in my opinion, and let me just say this, whatever I say, if it in any way contradicts what's taught in this house, disregard it. That's real, because I'm not here to bring any type of confusion or conflict to what is taught, but just understand the principle in which I teach it, and it may make sense. So in essence, there's four seasons to a successful relationship, as I've kind of coined it. So season number one would be the dating season. That is the selection process. Season number two is committed courtship. That is the getting to know you phase. Season number three is engagement. That is the season of preparation. Season number four is marriage, and that should be the final frontier. But going back to the dating season, anybody ever been on a job before? Job interview before? Job interview? Okay. Some time ago, many years ago, at least in the States, whenever you went on a job interview, if the interview went kind of good, the employer could say, you know what, I like you, you're hired. Today, it seems as though there is a process that you need to go through. So you may have three or four different interviews. You're interviewing with the headhunter, you're interviewing with the manager, you're interviewing with the supervisor, you're interviewing with the head of the company. You're interviewing with different people, and then they will come together and have a meeting, and they say, well, based upon my thoughts, I think this. So there is almost like a conversation where everybody's looking at you from a different vantage point to see if you would be a good fit for the company, right? I think dating should be the same way. The problem that we run into as we do things the world's way is that I'm going to choose who I want for me and leave everybody out of the equation. So I don't care what mama says and daddy says and pastor says and friend says. And even though everybody can see that this person may not be right for you, because I'm basing it on physical attraction and emotional desirability, then common sense is thrown out and we make decisions that aren't best for us. So I believe that you should have three P's when you're going through the dating process or the selection process. P number one, you always want to have a good peer that you value, that you esteem, that can see things that you can't see, because you're emotionally connected and tied to that person, whereas they may not be. And if they are in the Word and they are basing their lives on a biblical foundation, they can give you some wisdom and advice about the person that you may be interested in. Then, depending upon your age, you may want to go to a parent, because let me tell you, every single female that I ever brought into my house didn't have to utter a word to my mother. She knew automatically that's not the one. She would rule them out automatically. I'm like, Ma, you never even spoke to her. You never said hi. You never had a conversation. Something about my mother, she just knew. When Danielle came in the room, never a negative word. There was something that she knew and she sensed. So a parent could be a good P. The third P could be a pastor or a spiritual authority, somebody that you value and you esteem, that you go to for advice. And as long as you have a community of people that you trust that are part of your process, I can't see how your selection could be wrong. I can't see how the dating season could be wrong, because you're not having sex anyway, right? You're having great conversations to see if there's chemistry, right? If you two have common interests and common goals, and if you do, you then transition into the next season. So as long as it's being done with biblical principles, don't get caught up in the word, but get caught up in the process to get you from I do to, excuse me, from hi, my name is to I do. Does that make sense? Okay.